Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the analysis of Fuleno TV. I hope you well from wherever you're watching this channel. I want to take you to something that is happening in Elgeyo Marakwet because residents have given William Ruto an ultimatum. You know, this is the time I understand some of those fired cabinet secretaries have gone to the people, using the people to fight for them, because now they want to bring the debate of how many votes they gave William Ruto. That is what is happening, ladies and gentlemen. It is trying to probably twist William Ruto into making a decision that is going to favor them, some of them to go back. You know, someone like Murkomen, and I'm going specifically on Murkomen because William Ruto and Murkomen are buddies ever since those days they were in ODM. So I want to share a small video here from the residents and the reaction they have given and the ultimatum they gave William Ruto about reappointing Murkomen. But before you get there, please like this video. It's so important if you like this video, and I'm so grateful for everyone who has been liking our videos. I don't take that for granted. Subscribe to our channel if you've not subscribed before, and to existing subscribers, thank you so much for your support. The residents of Elgeyo Marakwet seems to be unhappy over the decision that Ruto took of firing all the cabinet secretaries.
Tulipika 100% kura. Lakini chuzi mimi nashangaa watu wa washingishwa. Alisema kwamba tuna kufika saa 10 tunasherehekea Murkomen akuja nyumbani. Sisi tukisema waje tu karibishe rais nyumbani 2027. Watu itakuwa namna gani? Sitakuwa mbaya. So tunataka Murkomen arutishwe pale pake parot. Sisi hatuna ubaya kuna Murkomen. Hiyo ni mtoto yetu na tunapenda yeye sana. Tunataka yeye utabutie mali aruti pale pake halafu tukae kwa salama.
Murkomen before chakulia kwa wasiri, Murkomen alikuwa senator wetu na tulikuwa tukimpenda sana, na alikuwa katika awamu yake ya tatu kwa senate. Na kwa mambo yenye inatokea Kenya msima, tunachua Murkomen ni mtu tunampenda sana, na ni mtu ametufanyia kazi bila ubakuzi, na ni mtu alikuwa akiunganisha watu wote wa eneo hili. Ile mambo yote yenye yanasunguka hii Kenya msima, tunachua wale wenye wameanzisha hii mambo na tunawachua ni lengo yao.
You know, personally I think that was the best that William Ruto could have done, to fire all, to dissolve the cabinet, so that it doesn't appear as if he's favoring particular regions. So the fact that he fired the whole cabinet at least gave him some space to breathe. But the people in Elgeyo Marakwet, especially the citizens there, are not taking it lightly. This matter, they avowed that it's either William Ruto gives Murkomen back the cabinet slot, or they won't vote for him. That is the message that is being sent to William Samoei Ruto. So in this case, ladies and gentlemen, Ruto appears to be someone who is under a siege, under immense siege from the people of Elgeyo Marakwet.
Tunaomba serikali sana kwa ajili ya mtoto wetu Murkomen ambaye ni siasa ya barabara, alikuwa senator wetu. Alafu maneno ya serikali ambayo sisi raia wenye tulivuka kura 100%. Hatujui mbele wala nyuma. Tunaomba serikali sana arudishe CS Murkomen ili akivika huko. Tunaongea na yeye sisi kama wenyeji wa Marakwet.
Because if that is the case, and Kenyans are looking at Murkomen as someone who was exhibited a lot of opulence, something that Kenyans are not willing to, you know, to stomach, you know, this fact that most politicians wanaonyesha utajiri wao publicly, you know, hiyo ni kitu ambao most Kenyans have said no.
When I watch it, when I owe it, it quickly, it was like 400,000, 700,000. So it has its own
shamba.
So it's Ruto is now, you know, trading on a very delicate balance here, because now if the people of Elgeyo Marakwet who are going to vote for him again, if he goes back, if he seeks a re-election, if those people are saying that the only way we can vote for you is if you accord our own son, you know, Murkomen, a cabinet slot. You know, they don't want anything else apart from a cabinet slot. And they are going to an extent of saying Murkomen was a senator. They had picked him as a senator, but he picked him and gave him a cabinet slot, and thereby denying him an opportunity to serve them as in the capacity of a senator. So it's either they give Murkomen back the position that he had given him, or they don't vote for him again. That is the message, ladies and gentlemen. Let's take, for example, Murkomen does not get that appointment back. Remember, there is 2025, 2026 and 2027. So all these 3 years, Murkomen will be in the cold. Labda benefit ambayo atakuwa anapata maybe ni zile tenders za serikali, anapata tenders za serikali na survive, kama vile tulisikia Millicent Omanga. Millicent Omanga alisemekana anakula zile tenders za serikali, lakini we don't have facts to prove that, but that is what is being said. Na kuna kitu wasoli walisema, lisemwalo lipo, na kama halipo basi liko njiani. I hope you understand that point. So William Ruto is now forced to make a decision on whether he wants to sacrifice his ambition, because when he, if he decides to bring back Murkomen, which I personally give it a 70% chances that William Ruto will bring back Murkomen. You know, there are ministers in that cabinet who I believe William Ruto will bring back. And one of them is Murkomen. The second person I believe William Ruto will bring back is Kithure Kindiki. That one, I am 100% sure Ruto will bring those people back, because of for Kithure Kindiki is aiming at consolidating his base in Tharakanithi. Because mind you, Mount Kenya has already shown indication of splitting. There are factions that will not vote for William Ruto. There is a faction of the lower Mount Kenya, those sides of Tharaka Nithi, Embu, Meru. Those are the sides which might vote for William Ruto. But these other sides, Nyeri, Karatinas, Kiambu, these are places that have shown open rebellion to William Ruto, and he doesn't bank on those regions anymore. So, probability that William Ruto will bring back Kithure Kindiki iko juu. Murkomen pia anaona kwamba akiregeshwa. Personally, naona kama ikiwa hivyo. I know this is not something that people want. People want a totally different cabinet of technocrats, business people, people who are learned and not politicians. But that is what the constitution says. No politician in the cabinet slot. But we all know very well, ladies and gentlemen, that William Ruto will go out of his way na akosewa Kenya kidogo by bringing back Murkomen, Kithure Kindiki. These are people who will find their way back in the cabinet. But one person whom people have been calling out, Afutwe, ni prime cabinet secretary. Mind you, prime cabinet secretary position is an appointee of William Ruto. He was appointed. In fact, that position doesn't exist in the cabinet, in the constitution. It doesn't. So Mudavadi was simply given that position as a reward. So he was appointed. He was not elected in that position. So, ladies and gentlemen, what do you make of this sudden realization that William Ruto is facing it? The locals in Elgeyo Marakwet are making their demands known to William Ruto that they're not going to take anything less than their one of their own getting an appointment back. They want Murkomen to be reappointed. That is a problem. Someone whom I also think William Ruto might recall back, it's Aisha Jumwa, going by the history of Aisha Jumwa and William Ruto. Or maybe if that is not the case, then he might opt to give Aisha Jumwa a lighter position somewhere, ili ajishikilie tu pale, because Aisha Jumwa will be in the cold for the next 3 years. Vie for gubernatorial election, doesn't win, again in the cold for another 5 years. So, nafikiri kama Aisha Jumwa atapewa nafasi. Those three people, I guarantee. So, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to rest my case there. But what do you think about this sudden revelation about the people of Elgeyo Marakwet demanding that Ruto reappoints Murkomen ama wasimpatie kura? That is an ultimatum which has been issued to William Ruto. What do you make of that? So, perhaps if you're watching this video and you're not subscribed, take 1 second and subscribe, like this video. Until you catch up again, stay safe and stay blessed.